Why, hello there. My name is Guilherme Suárez and I study Physics Engineering at Instituto Superior Técnico. As of now, I'm working on my master thesis in particle physics, and during the following 3 minutes, I will hopefully make you understand more about the topic of my thesis. So, let's start from the beginning. Well, kind of. Ever since the ancient Greece, we have been concerned with understanding the building blocks of which we are made of. In this quest for knowledge, during the 20th century, particle physics was developed and the most successful theory thus far was created, the Standard Model. The Standard Model describes what we think are the elementary particles of our universe and their interactions. And as of now, every piece of the puzzle has been found. One might ask then, is the search for new particles finished? No. While the Standard Model is very successful in explaining most of what we have seen, it does have some glaring flaws, such as not being able to explain neutrino masses, the oscillations between their flavors, or not having candidates for dark matter. So does this then mean that the Standard Model is wrong? Well, yes, but actually no. So bear with me for a minute. Although the Standard Model doesn't explain some very important phenomena that we have seen, there are several extensions that can be done which build on top of it. These might include new particles, like dark matter candidates, and are part of what is known as beyond the Standard Model physics. If we know that there are physics beyond the Standard Model, why haven't we been able to see them then? In order to answer this, we need to first know how the experiments are made. We have known for the past century that energy can be transformed into mass, and so, at places like the LHC, we accelerate bunches of particles very close to the speed of light and make them collide, and consequently interact with each other while hopefully creating new particles. Since these are stochastic processes, with a bit of luck, we manage to produce the ones that we want. One of the reasons as to why we may not have seen any exotic particle might be because we still haven't reached energies high enough to create them, since they are so heavy. But this is not the only possibility. In fact, we might have already surpassed the necessary energy in order to produce some of these particles, but were just not able to detect them. Although particle production is a stochastic process, it is not entirely random. We know that some particles interact more with others, and as such, they are more likely to be created. Most of these beyond the Standard Model extensions predict particles that interact very feebly with the ones we know, and as such, we consider them to be in the hidden sector. This means that in order to see these particles, we need to increase the intensity of our experiments and have very specific detectors that not only search for characteristic decays, which are expected to happen within very large distances, but also rule out all the undesired processes, leading to zero background. The Search for Hidden Particles experiment, or SHiP, is going to try to do this in order to discover particles from the hidden sector. But since it is such a big endeavor, we need to make sure that things are done as well as possible, and that we don't miss any crucial opportunities. As such, I'm currently performing simulations that will try to optimize the selection of these exotic particles in the SHiP experiment. By doing this, hopefully we will have both no false negatives and no false positives once the experiment is up and running. Thank you for watching, and if you want to learn more about the SHiP experiment as well as beyond the Standard Model physics, head to the SHiP website or contact someone within the SHiP division at LIP. Ever since ancient Greece, we have been concerned with understanding.